Previously on...
Yo, nobody got time for that, let's go!
Michelle, though, she wanted to do more. She took a much greater interest in the time window than Tensai after a while. She really wanted to push it to its limits. And most of the things we can do, like those fancy weapons and outfits, were all a result of her research. She's always looking out for us, even if she does seem stern and controlling.
I nodded and went silent, letting us walk together as we stopped into the small suburb. Eventually, we got to the store.
Nice!
I wonder what store we're going.
Oh! Okay. I'm cool with that. Yeah.
I missed the title of it, but before I knew it, I was surrounded by women's lingerie.
Yeah.
What?
Shh, Tenshi, calm down. Look, I was dumb yesterday and left my bra on when I went through the time window.
What, you did?
So I wanted to get a new one.
Oh, it broke.
Damn.
Does that happen often, girl?
More often than I'm willing to admit, perv.
What the I'm just asking a question here.
Damn. What's with all these girls calling me perv, man?
Damn. Don't judge me.
Oh, no. I didn't mean.
Shut up and help me look.
Alright, Kyo. She took my hand and giggled playfully, pulling me deeper into the racks of clothing. I was slowly realizing how risque her current outfit was and was wondering how she was okay wearing it even in public.
It's fine. I could see her nips, but hey, it's fine.
I thought it was just an around the lab sort of outfit, but apparently not. She held up a lacy black bra and held it to her chest.
Can I see that, please? Damn!
How's this look to you, Kenji?
Yeah, can I see the actual bra on you, girl? You know what I'm saying? I mean, this game's about titties, right? And, you know, time machines and stuff, yeah.
Damn!
Game, you should've... You know what? Never mind. Going on.
Good. Looks nice. Yeah, I don't see it, but yeah, it looks nice.
Amazing response, Kenji. Glad I brought you with me.
She responded sarcastically, rolling her eyes but still smiling as she returned the bra to the rack and pulled out another.
Yo! I mean, whatever.
This happened for a while, bra after bra, as she continued looking through them until she found one she really wanted.
Oh, this one is a front claps. I should try this one on. I don't have one of these yet. Come on, Kenji. I need your opinion.
What?
Before I could say anything else, I was being dragged to the fitting room, Kyo disappearing behind one of the doors and fiddling with her outfit.
Can I look inside?
I stood outside awkwardly, shuffling my feet and waiting for her to make a decision. Suddenly, the door flew open to reveal...
Oh, reveal Kyo! Oh! Dickish! What do you think? Dickish! That is huge!
In fact, you look nice, Kyo.
Yeah, damn. I like the lacy outfit. Yeah, I don't know about the bow, but yeah. Girl, you look fine. Damn, that is huge. Well, not as huge as, you know, when you went through the time window, but yeah. Damn, girl. Damn.
What do you think?
Kyo? Do you really think it's okay to be out in just a bra and...
Just hurry up and give me your opinion. Does it look nice or what?
She held her hand up to them, and I had to try my hardest to keep from having a nosebleed. Oh, I nodded, giving a slow thumbs up. Yeah!
She giggled again, shutting the door and finishing up her business. She's doing this on purpose, isn't she? I muttered. Back to myself before the door swung open, Kyo being fully covered again, much to my relief and dismay. She took me by the arms and went up to the front counter, paying for the piece of lingerie before escorting me out with a smile. You just bought one bra? I mean, I'm cool with that, but don't you want to buy more? You know? I mean, you know what? I'm cool with that. Yeah.
Thanks again for coming with me, Genji.
It's no problem, Kyo.
I had a great time. Yeah.
I just kinda wanted to get your mind off stuff. Off the lab. Off that incident with my boobs.
What? I could feel things suddenly go very serious, the mood shifting dramatically as she said the word incident. The boobs? The tits? What incident? Titty incident? Yeah.
I'm sorry, I shouldn't have brought it up.
It's fine. Kyo, really. About my family. Yeah, not titties. What am I saying? Yeah. I think I need to talk about it eventually. I just don't know if I'm ready yet or not. I felt her hands slip around my arms until she took my hands in hers. I looked up and saw her look me in the eye, comforting yet direct.
If you ever need someone to talk to, Kenji, I'm here, okay? I may not have known you long, but we're friends now. That's the way things are when you join up with us, okay?
I took her in words before letting out a slight nod, giving her a smile. She beamed back at me.
Good. Now, let's get home.
She paused and let out a yawn.
I'm tired.
Whoa.
I need to lay down.
Well? Oh. Well, too bad. We got a mission to take care of.
Oh, what? Now? Come on, Michelle. I just got home.
Should have thought of that. Could have happened before you left, Kyo. Now, go get ready. Kenji, get up to the front deck. Get up to the front deck, I mean.
Alright then.
Kyo slightly miffed, went back to her room to get ready. Rose was nearby in the lab already, smiling over at me.
Hey, Rose!
She stepped over, her outfit more revealing than I was used to on her. Really?
I think it's the same.
Oh, used to. Yeah. She wore a dress, right? Yeah.
So, did you have fun?
It was interesting, yeah. To say the least. Yeah.
Yeah, hey. Kyo is usually a type that has a bit too much fun while she's out. She gets you into any trouble while you were out there?
No. Just shopped and came back, you know? Yeah. I didn't see titties. Yeah. Where are you guys headed?
London. Just before the plague. We think we might have a reading on Krontek over there, so we're going to investigate.
Gotcha. Well, be careful out there then.
Huh? Thanks, Kenji. But even if it was way before my time, it's still my neck of the woods.
She winked and stepped over to the portal, watching it light up as Kyo stepped up to the platform. A grumpy look on her face.
Cheer up, Kyo. At least you get to the big boob again for a while.
Rose was obviously ribbing her, but I could tell that this suggestion was somehow comforting to Kyo as she softened her composure just a little.
You're not wearing bra, right? You just bought the bra. You're not wearing it, right? It looks like you're not. Yeah, you're not. Good.
Yeah, that's true.
Whoa. The light erupted from the center of the machines, signaling that the time window was ready to step through, and the two of them did.
Whoa!
I merely watched behind them as they excited. exited. Wow. Michelle by my side as he worked the interface.
Alright, they should be fine out there. I'll be keeping an eye on them as usual. Feel free to join me on that.
Of course. Yeah. Whoa!
Here we go again.
Whoa! Seriously? You're not used to this by now because...
It's not exactly something I can just get used to, Kyo. My boobs get bigger than my head in less than a minute. It's not the most natural thing to have.
Just as she mentioned it, they puffed up like they always did.
Oh!
She wiggled in place, watching as her breasts sway from side to side, getting larger by the second. Kyo watched as her friend and teammates struggled with her growth and giggled as her own bust began to push outward into her clothing.
Oh! Dickish! That is huge!
Kyo playfully poked them back and forth alternately with each index finger.
何遊んでんだよ、おい!
Laughing and enjoying the pleasing feeling, she looked back up at Rose.
Damn! I love how you wink, girl. Damn!
Do yours feel good when they grow too?
どんだけだよ?
Oi! Rose said nothing, merely biting her lips and nodding, trying not to block out the feeling Kyo had just brought up.
Well, moving them around isn't gonna help, silly.
Kyo walked over to her friend and settled her, grabbing her shoulder.
There you go. Know that no one else doesn't help the feeling?
What?
Swifting and suddenly, with a wide smile on her face, Kyo moved her hands from Rose's shoulder to her chest too, squeezing her boobies tightly to feel them resist and pushed him into her palms.
Ow!
Rose nearly screamed, pulling away from her friend and panting, exasperated from the feeling.
Oh!
Okay, yeah, no. How about you never do that again?
Hee hee. It's just too easy with you, Rose.
Oh, London!
And here we are. Gosh, what happened here?
Rose stepped over to the building in front of her, seeing the destruction. It had been largely reduced to a pile of white ash, its remaining beams blackened and charred.
Might be the work of Krontek. I'll keep an eye out while you investigate.
Good plan.
How many times have they gone back through the time window? Michelle?
Quite a few times, but nothing substantial. I think they're just barely broken 15 times now. I don't actually keep track.
Okay. It grows 15 times?
Damn.
Even through a time window, I could hear the two of them conversing about what they saw, as well as other things.
What kind of people are those two anyway?
I mean, they seem normal enough to me.
Their boobs don't get nearly as big as ours, though.
I wouldn't say that. They still get pretty huge to me. I think.
I don't know. Mine always feel like a pair of watermelons strapped on my body.
Yours aren't that big, Rose. Sheesh. I mean, they could be if you really wanted to.
No. That's just fine by me, Kyo.
You know, to tell the truth, man, that is huge. I mean, I think it's the size of a watermelon. Maybe bigger? Goddamn!
So, anyway, how do we actually know Krontek caused this in the first place?
That's why we're checking. Michelle figured out the location. She said she didn't detect them in the time, so they were able to do some damage. Unfortunately, but not that seemed too detrimental to the time stream.
Well, that's good to hear then.